787 Greenliner.
Welcome to our sustainable flight today.
First officer Sharifa.
Hi.
Very lightweight.
In our sustainable lovely made of bamboos.
It's 100% recycled. So this here is our butterfly cap made from recycled curtains.
So lots of this stuff are actually invisible.
This is our route to avoid contrails.
How many tons of CO2 emission you think we saved due to all the initiative today?
Today I'm traveling on a special Etihad 787 Greenliner.
Welcome to our sustainable flight today.
I'm a little skeptical about the sustainable flight because there are lots of talks and marketing, but very little things has been done.
Perhaps, Sam, you will feel more than you will see. You'll obviously see eco-friendly products, less single-use plastic on board, and more waste segregation. So this is something you'll definitely see. But what you will experience is a flight that has 70% less emissions than a conventional one. And that's owing to the SAF use, the sustainable aviation fuel blend, 38% that is used on this flight, as well as the operational efficiencies that we're demoing.
My name is Mimmo. Today with me we have First Officer Sharifa.
Hi.
And today we are flying the sustainable flight Etihad EY20 from London to Abu Dhabi. We will start from an optimized climb, so we will be voided any restrictions during our climb, so it will be a continuous climb to cruise level. The flight time is going to be 6 hours and 10 minutes at 39,000 feet. We have coordinated with all the control areas that we are overflying towards Abu Dhabi, a lot of optimized routes, so we're going to get a lot of direct routing, we'll short our distance, and we let us emit less CO2. Also, we're going to have a continued descent coordinated with Abu Dhabi, with an RNAV star and an RNAV approach. We will guarantee us a continued descent up to the landing using the minimum fuels as possible.
I heard you got your PPL license.
I did, and I recently flew again. I flew a couple days ago in LA. And I just want to know, so you started with Etihad Academy, is that how
yes.
you started?
I started with Etihad Training Academy 12 years ago, and I flew the 320, 777, and now I'm flying 787 and 777.
Here is our plant-based water made from compost water plastic, and it's eco-friendly.
Can I see?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome.
It's interesting, she handed me a bottle of water. It was plastic, but she said that was made by plants. You know, it feels much harder than the plastic, but in my opinion they should just give you a water bottle, right? And fill the water bottle. I think what's funny about this airplane is the color it changes when it arrives. When it's bad weather, low lights, it looks more blue. Feet, so we took off and continued climbing. This is what the captain said, it's a continued saving flight.
This is our canopy service that comes in a sustainable plate made of bamboos. You have here a courgette roll, the spiced sweet potato tart, and the chicken salty mocha.
Okay.
Enjoy.
Seriously, I got really tired because I flew from LA to New York and I flew that JetBlue flight to London to join on this plane. So it's almost like a marathon. But when I see the engine, it always gives me some great energy when I see that I'm flying.
Thank you. Hi Sam, how's it going? Just setting up our trays for our main meal service in economy today. We just want to really stress, our trays normally do contain a lot of plastic, but today we have absolutely zero plastic on our trays. We have our rotable recycled containers, which can be reused. We also have our lightweight stainless steel cutlery.
Very lightweight, so like tiny weight, and actually it's quite sharp as well. So this is pretty good, like it gives people like using actually a real cutlery instead of plastic.
And last but not least, don't forget about the tray. It's 100% recycled. So this here is our butterfly cup. It's completely biodegradable and made from recycled materials.
What do you have inside? Popcorn?
Inside, inside we're using it for the hot beverages on board today, so our tea and coffee.
Man, I passed out. I was so tired after takeoff. You know, I reclined my seats. It was comfortable and I just passed out. I just woke up now and they're already finished dinner. So I'm gonna have my meal first. Then I'm gonna discover more. So I came on board, was looking for more sustainability stuff, right? But I just realized a lot of these stuff are actually invisible because the SAF fuel in the fuel tank, I can't see it. The waste stuff turning to recyclable material, I can't see the process of production. But in my opinion, I want to see more sustainable flight. This is a great pilot project from airline in the Middle East to take that lead. Not only one time, I want to see it every month, every week, every day. We could do something like this. That would be amazing.
My name is Harun Junaidi, and my son here is Rafa Junaidi.
And you can see what he's playing, 787 model. Is that your favorite?
Yeah, it's my very favorite aircraft.
How do you think about a sustainable flight?
I'm really pleased with the experience. I witnessed a lot of good things like sustainable biodegradable bottles, sustainable cups, organically and sustainable source food, and then there was the lightweight metal cutlery, so which I've never seen before. All in all, it all adds up to save tons and tons of CO2, which was the main goal of this flight experience.
Sam, do you realize where this bag came from?
It really looked familiar. I know the old Etihad pattern, but I couldn't figure out where they came from.
This bag, in fact, made from recycled curtains from our old aircraft.
The curtains.
And would you look at this? This beautiful tote bag. Every single one of the guests on our flight today gets to take home one of these with them. It's completely reusable.
Okay. And I would definitely take home now. It's a piece of collectible
please.
As well. The curtain.
Welcome back to Abu Dhabi, my hometown. We had a beautiful flight trying to save the planet, saving fuel, less CO2 emission today, maybe less than any of my flights I've done in the last 12 years.
It's
so proud to be part of this team.
How did the ATC help you out with this flight? How much time do you think we saved?
So basically, in London, what they did is they removed the restriction of 6,000 feet on the SID. So as you know this, we were only level for 6,000 feet for about 2 minutes. Then we were taken off the SID by radar heading and we were given a straight climb to flight level 370. So this will save us a lot of fuel and about 3-4 minutes in time.
And what about the continued descent? I think we did really well, right?
Yes, the continued descent, that we got the restriction removed between Bahrain FIR and UAE FIR. So we had an optimal top of descent. We were assigned an RNAV star and an RNAV AR approach on run and 1-3 right in Abu Dhabi, which was the closest one for us. So we got a very nice and sure approach on continuous descent. Yeah. During taxi, we shut down the left engine. We arrived here at the gate. We didn't start the APU. The ground power unit was connected and then we shut down the other engine. So we also saved some fuel by not starting the APU. Another technology we are trialing on this flight, which I didn't tell you at the beginning, is we had a partnership with Satavia. Satavia is a company that provides forecast to avoid contrails during the flight. So today we were avoiding contrails. They came up with us with this profile, if you can see. This is our route, and the area marked in green are low area where low probability of contrails are, and then you have the yellow and the red. So our route was crossing the red around the border between Hungary and Romania, and what we did basically, we climb above this red area to avoid making contrails. Contrails, the study says a lot of contrails, they make impossible for the heat to escape. So avoiding contrails will make sure that our planet doesn't warm up as fast as it's doing now.
So the final question is, how many tons of CO2 emission you think we saved due to all the initiative today?
So due to all the initiative we have today in our flight, I can say that we saved around 7 tons of CO2, which was not emitted in the air today.
Thanks for having me. It's a great flight today and hope we do more sustainable flight in the future.
Thank you, Sam, for being with us. See you soon. Bye.